walked in here a minute ago.
Oh, did you?
Go on. Are you on?
Yeah.
I'll just follow his throat. Just keep steady with him. Don't go on the throat. Keep going. Go on. Turn around. Go on. Go on. I want him to go away.
Yes.
Tight.
the bruised cheek, if you like, on the back of the recovery vehicle that's into that lot, so the session should be able to continue, although no doubt drivers having seen this warning, if you like, will be far more circumspect due to the 30 minutes more caution.
Number 7 comes in 1 3 4 tradition. the left hand to the right hander at McLean. Play still and very confident driving. Sideways on through the old hairpin. He's got copious amounts of paper around to try and capture as many numbers as they come down. The one great thing about this is that if that very splendid Chris Ward Portiera comes through red gate on the first lap, I shall have no trouble picking it out. It looks enormous and very well livery. Chris Wood already sideways through the old head. He'll hit about 45 miles per hour. It's a bit of a bruiser, that thing, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I just got
it drop. Yeah, it's very dry over here now.
So, Lee Adams, he's around. Alongside him on that front open bridge is Roger Edmund, who's come up from Sulphur Championship in his SR2. He's just far next weekend in the SR2 Championship. So, he's on time with seven.
Shape of Roger Hebden and everybody scrambling for grip in the braking area of the old hairpin, just watching them all gingerly tiptoe their way through. And that's probably makes absolute sense on the opening lap, because you don't want to go throwing things away when this is a 10 lap race, remember. But the race organization is not in fair, but Chris Wood leads in second. Thank you.
I'm not sure. the one on the left bumper is Woodbridge, appearing in close at the end. So that by the flag call, he was only, what, 3 seconds adrift rather than 4 or 5 that he had been earlier on. Lee Allen comes home in third place, he's going to sweep.
I have a sweep because the 6th place after the sweep has
too hard on his right-hand pedal, causing himself problems. Yeah, Chris Wood didn't come past us in the set, so whether he's pulled off into the paddock or not.
Well, back ball, we'll have a word, first of all, with Richard Neary, seeing that he has...
ask him about the brakes, David. Was it the brakes? Ask him.
I've wanted to work for a speaker ball, so I'm not... Okay, I'm not talking to Richard Neary. He got his gloves off. Speak with him for a while. Right, gloves off. Not a bad first couple of laps there from 6th row of the grid up to 2nd place, was it?
No, it was alright really. I think Chris had the look of me really. If I could have been with him to start with, maybe I'd have given him a bit of fight, but I was too far back really. I think if I'd been closer, we might have had a really good race, but as it was, Chris had the best of me on the day. It was a good race though, it was quite interesting, quite exciting.
Well done. McGarland and Silver Salver from Kevin Shorty, the championship coordinator. Right, Lee Allen, first of all. A very good qualifying performance, but I think more battle cars getting the better of you.
Yeah, they've got 250 to 300 horsepower more than me, so I just tried my best and I could stay with them on the short part of the circuit, but when we got these two long straights, yeah, absolutely, I can't do nothing about it. I just have to let them go. I can't think of a blamey blocker. But it was a good race, I enjoyed it. I mean, I didn't give up because I could still see them. There was no one behind me, so I had nothing to lose. I haven't got nothing to lose anyway. Kept on trying, and I was quicker through the plane and stuff, and if I can chase them and they make a mistake, they're all well and good, but they never.
Right, well done. With more of the Allen family, Les, and a class win for you. Now, tell us about Roger Edmund at the last corner. Did he fall off, or you didn't have to tap him by any chance?
No, I tapped him over the back once, but coming to chicane, he just basically locked up, and I was going to have to give up in 2 laps, so I could hardly breathe, to be honest. But Roger, unfortunately, locked it by the last minute, just went down the escape road. Did he finish?
Yeah, behind you, second in class, so that'll do it.
Yeah, that'll do.
Now, why were you not breathing?
It's a bit old for us, I suppose. No, it's warm out here. I'm really pleased. I've always wanted to win a Donington, that's the first one, so I'm really pleased with that.
Right, well done. Congratulations, then. Kevin Shaw, this is about in class knowledge and wisdom.
We've awarded the Drive Today Award to Les Allen for that super drive, and the Best Prepared Award goes to the winner of the race, Chris Wood, for his preparation.
Right, well, we haven't got Chris Ward as yet to talk to, but Les Allen stepped this way once again and received Driver of the Day Award. So not only a class win, but Driver of the Day as well. Does he get a garland for this? No, he doesn't. Well, never mind. Well, you saw a few quid, yeah, all right. Dig deep in Kevin Trump's pocket. Right, more thanks,
on the inside, but I think it's just that his indicators are not 20 kind of moment.
place is for Richard Lambert, with the leader of Class 2 reporting Lambert in
thank you.
happens as well, but there should be exciting nonetheless. And we've got a chat that's happy again in Scotland in his exhibition park here for the
bell. Now we've had lunch on the terrace, you know, and watch the show drop from the opening bar. And we'll see Mark. Take him in there. It's Mark.
Mark, give me Mark. I'm going to store it,
Mark. No. Well, so yeah, anyway, Mark. Well, that's all we've got now. And we've got the leader through. We've got somebody else in particular which is 95 Mark Hobson. Sadly, despite his best efforts, he's not going to get out of the gravel trap. The members of the British Motor Racing Box Club running to his aid, and he's just had a spin there. And I was going to tell you who went through it. I suspect it might well have been there, if Neil Chillystone, who had the runs, but I may have proved to be wrong.
Did you mention how Red House?
No, he was, he's come through in third.
Ah, right. Brilliant. Well, after the show, they come to return on turnout. So all those drivers on the opening lap really helped, and they lost Donington, who come through in the lead. Chris Ryan has been qualified yesterday in second place, third in the finish of the programme, and he agrees that he's fourth place to that hooker on Neil Chipson. His fifth mark is Claire Redgrave, off the back of the grid. Tremendous first lap there, 6th mark.
You know, here's a significant advantage. In addition to the happy green play, fourth of the Royal Nation Claire Redgrave, in fifth place, 47th, is Pascal Kitchen, does continue in the second place is still Chris Ryan to in second, and the idea of 27th is third in the happy green play, so he's maintaining that third position, up into fourth place now with that Kitchen Claire Redgrave that you mentioned. That's got her down to ninth position now, so after all that sterling work.
Ever so slowly, albeit at a much less quick pace than we would normally see.